cost, and that sure right is not here to look at Minnesota this morning, really, on the third year. If you notice, and I'm gonna go through this with you, if you look at the budget, county participates, county non-participates, part of a work called grant aid monies, there was a little bit of a and these monies are the county, county non-participating place is money above and beyond what they're legally required to do. County participating is what they have to by law give us. And then unreserved fund balance is what there's a fund balance that exists for if you don't get enough funds to meet your budget, you don't generate enough fees to meet your budget, you can draw from. Drew down $37,000. The total amount of that fund balance now in Lowndes is probably over $500,000. The reserve fund balance is prior year fees. What we collect this year will fund next year's budget. So when you see prior year fees, the reserve fund balance, that's what that means. Prior year administrative claiming is what we get for taking care of the administrative aspect of running the departments, of running the programs, of billing and collecting, and that also is applied to this year. And then, of course, there are other components to these that break down in the client fees, health check, nurse rotation we no longer have. We're still collecting on which they bill for her, and that's a whole other issue. And pretty much that's what you need to know here. Medicaid, perinatal case management is PCM, perinatal pregnancy-related services, and PRS, and there's so much more to the health department than people realize that we do. And I will tell you throughout this district, not just here, there are 250 employees throughout the district and 10 health boards. You, however, the Lee County, when I first came on a year and a half ago, I really didn't understand what Lee County was. We're the biggest county, you have the biggest fund balance. But you basically, out of the programs that we have a lot of programs, for example, with Women's Health and Children, which is a huge program, nutritional supplementation for underprivileged, that the Lee County basically is the fiscal agent and the responsible agent for programs that are not part of what the actual health department does as far as patients walking in the door, the immunization for family planning. Family planning is a program partly state, partly federal. I'm not going any more detailed into this. And of course, grant and aid, the very last item here, grant and aid is the money that we get from the state. I will tell you, grant and aid has basically, they came up with a new formula for the first time in 40 years that was implemented last year. However, and Lowndes took about $150,000 cut in its budget because of the new formula that was based on poverty rate, poverty share, and population. Because of that, we were seeing $150,000 cut all in 1 year. Well, then they decided to phase it in over 7 years, and 25 this year, 50 next year, 175 the next year, up 7 years, it'll be 150. Benedict Gerald, the new commissioner, worked with the legislature, the governor, last year, this year, that we were held harmless, meaning even though we were supposed to get a $25,000 cut last year, we didn't get it. Even though we were supposed to get a $50,000 cut this year, we didn't get it. Next year, you're going to see a $75,000 cut coming in just like that. And at the end of 7 years, we'll be getting $150,000 less than we were given after 7 years that we were given 2 years ago, based on the new formula. The new formula was, I'm not even going to go into details of that. So having said that, to explain in a nutshell the revenue part of the budget.